to see. I hope by now most of us have been able to download the data that we are going to use for this week. So today, yesterday we were able to look at how we can how we can load our data. Today we will just have a little bit of some look on how we can pre-process our data. So does anyone have any question in terms of loading the data? For those who are able to load the data, maybe. is there anyone with a question in how to upload the data? Okay, so maybe I'll assume that everyone was fine with loading the data, and we were both, all of us were able to load both the text data and also the audio data, and you were able to actually match the text data and the audio data together so that you're able to to see to come up with one data like a CSV file that matches both your audio data to the transcribed data that you're going to use for training. I don't know if there's anyone who had an issue in loading data. Okay, looks like none had an issue. Maybe all of us were able to load the data. So, I will proceed to share my screen. So I hope that everyone is able to see my screen now. So let's wait for this to start. Okay. Thanks, Rafa. So yesterday when we were looking at how to load our data, we got to understand that dealing with audio data is a little bit different in terms of how we have been dealing with how we have been dealing with the other data sets that we've been having. And we got to import our data using the LibRosa library. So let me just get from a few of us. How many have been able to visualize or to try and visualize their data, like we discussed yesterday? Okay. Okay, so maybe I want to maybe assume that from the responses I've gotten that we were able we're able to load our data and also to try and visualize the data. So one of the things that we do after loading our data is we are trying to understand the type of data set, the type of data that we have. And as we said yesterday, dealing with audio data, we get to look at two things. That is, we try and plot the graphs of the data so that we are able to see the spectrum of that given sound. Now, the spectrum of a given sound, when you are trying to look at the spectrum of a given sound, you're just trying to get the intensity of that sound and the frequency at given time intervals. So like in this one, using the LibroSa, we can see the color bar of this given sound data. And from this spectrum here, we will try to draw features from it so that those features we are going to use them the features we are going to use in modeling of our model, or creating a model from it, so that our model is just able to predict that this sound is gives us this given transcription or text of it. So let's try and look at a little bit of what we do in data augmentation. So we try and shift time so that the wave formats that we have can be in different time rates or sample rates. So this will try to move the waves in the right or in a given factor along the x-axis, which is now the time. So for us to achieve this, we have we use NumPy so that we can be able to roll a function that is going to generate for us a time shift for the given sound wave that we are dealing with. So from this notebook here, we can be able to see a given sound wave, and that given sound wave we can be able to draw like this one, we are able to like see the plot for the time against the amplitude, the frequencies of that given wave, and we are able also to shift the wave by the time so that we can have a graph like this. This is not a graph, but a spectrum like this. And then from this spectrum, we can be able to depict the stretching of time, and also we can be able to do the pitch shifting of that given sound wave. So like, for example, this one, if we play, we will be able to, if we play this given set of audio, and we'll be able to hear, and then we see how this graph is being plotted. So let's just try and play this and see. So from playing that given audio set or audio, we can be able to plot. This is the plot of the graph of the time against the amplitude. So, and then using NumPy, we've been able to create a spectrum for with the shift of time so that you're able to come up with this given spectrum of it. So other techniques for doing data augmentation is pitch shifting, or we stretch the time so that by stretching the time, we are able to see, we will be able to get to analyze in-depthly of the given frequency versus a given, versus a huger amount of time. So when we're able to do that, we'll be able to come up with the features of that given audio. So every audio signal consists of many features that it has, but we must extract different characteristics from it so that it becomes relevant to solve a given type of audio, so that you're able to come up with the transcriptions of it. So this process of extracting features so that we can use for the analysis is what we refer to as the feature extraction of the feature extraction. So in MEL spectrum or the frequency, we use what is called the MFCCs, the MEL frequency spectral coefficients. So this simply is just a small signal set of a given feature. Usually it's about 10 to 20, which are they concisely describe the overall shape of the spectrum envelope. So it models the characteristics of the human voice such that we are able to elongate maybe the given time frame so that we draw the different characteristics of a given wave or a given frequency at a given period of time. So like, for example, if you can see from this graph here, we've been able to elongate the time so that we can draw features at given time intervals. Like it becomes bigger so that we are able to depict the characteristics of this given the given sound wave that we have here. So after doing that, we just be able to come up with the alphabets, and then from that we'll be able to actually map the characteristics with the alphabets that that are given in the transcript in the map that you were able to come up with yesterday. I'm not sure if up to that point that makes sense. Maybe I can get a confirmation. Yes, Biruk.
So my question is, why we need to augment our data in our case? I mean, is it because we don't have enough training data, or does it give us some other advantage?
Okay. Okay, so augmenting the data is for us just to, it's not that we don't have enough data, but it gives us a good amount of training of every given data data audio that we have, so that we are able to like depict the small features of every given audio set that we have from our data. I don't know if that makes sense, Biruk.
Yeah, actually it makes sense.
Okay. Yes, Rafa.
Yes, it's about also the augmentation of the data. Is it like, so because when I was searching for that, it's like at some point they say that you have to, it's changing the, like it will start, it will go to left and right. And I mean, just a split, kind of a split in the audio. From the left or from the right or something like that. So how and is it like there are so many different methods for doing that for the augmentation?
I didn't get your question quite clearly. I don't know if you can repeat again.
Yeah, actually, I'm not sure that it's how to just rehearse it, but it's like I mean. The process of augmentation itself for the audio file, audio data. Is it like we are just moving the, I'm not sure how to say this. So if you can just go again for the part where we do the augmentation, exactly how we do it. Yes, yeah. Time shifting. Okay, so yeah, so it's like we are just shifting from left to right and the same audio that we have, right?
Yes.
Okay. So.
Yes. So another thing you'll realize when you're handling the challenge, one of the requirements is that we are trying to make sure that the noise that could be there with our data doesn't bring our model to perform badly, like I'm trying to get the right words to use. But you're trying to reduce as much noise as possible from our data. That is why we try and collect the features from the given data set by doing a data augmentation.
So it's not only about just increasing the data, the size of the data, but it's also about how well we can get more clean data for somehow, right? So that when I reduce the noise, I see.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
I saw Biruk's hand. Biruk?
Yeah, maybe. I think she asks for any other data augmentation techniques on audio data. So. We are actually doing shifting time in this case, but we can also do many other kinds of data augmentation, like injecting some kind of noise. We can change the pitch, the speed of the audio, and many other things we can do and need to play with the audio data.
Yeah. Okay. Do we have someone else with a question? Amon is asking if we do analysis for a single audio file. Yes, so yes, Anastasia.
Okay, just to answer Amon, like Desmond was saying from the beginning of the class, That's why we were doing the metadata generation yesterday and trying to combine these single files into one kind of like a CSV format kind of data, so that now you can train with multiple audio files. You can't just train a model with one single file. You have to combine them into one data set, then now use that for training. Is that clear, Amon?
Amon, is that clear? That is clear now. Okay. Yeah, for the EDA part, that is because you realize that the data that we have is it's a huge data set. So when you're trying to understand your analysis, you're trying to explore the audio data. I think you'll only use one file to try and get an understanding of the wave plots, because you can't do the wave plots with all the data that is given. Okay. So. I don't know if there's anyone else with a question. Okay. So it looks like we don't have anyone with a question further. So with audio preprocessing, there's not much to cover, but the much that will be covered will be in terms of now creating the models to take in the audio data and give us now the transcription. The transcription data. So I don't know if maybe there's someone with something to add. So maybe if there's none with something to add, I think maybe we can stop there and then we give you more time to work for those who have not been able to load the data. Okay, so I think we can continue more on Slack, and then we see how we solve the challenges that everyone faces.